Welcome back to the workshop. What you're looking at here is something that's got me really excited. AMT has re-released the Enterprise D in 1/2500th scale. Why am I so excited? Well, because one, it includes all the decals that we're going to need to do the full Aztec, the windows and everything. So painting is kept to a minimum, quite easy on this one. And because this is my absolute favorite Star Trek ship. Now, I normally don't go over the boxes, but on these Star Trek models from round two, I want you guys to see that. They give not only full decal guides in color, but they give a full paint guide as well, letting you know where each decal goes and where every bit of paint is going to go in full color on every side of the box, top and bottom, and it lets you replicate the filming model as close as possible to a model in this scale. Now we're gonna get some big pieces of plastic out. Yeah, it's 1/2500th scale, but the Enterprise D is a massive spaceship. So you can see that the nacelles are huge. I mean, you know, they're the length of a big index finger. We've got the main hull there or whatever. I don't know the exact names of these, and that's okay. I love the show, but I don't have to know the exact name of every little tiny thing on it to enjoy building a model, and neither do you. Their main thing is to have fun. This is a snap kit, so it'll be easy to put together. I'll be using glue just to hold everything securely, and then we'll be painting it and decaling it, but the gray that it's molded in is almost a metallic sheen to it and could be used exactly as it is. And you could just start painting and decaling right over the top of it if you so chose. You can see the beautiful detail on the molds is still there. This kit's been out a couple times and it's still wonderful every time it comes out. I've never actually built the Enterprise D. I don't know why. So this will be a first for all of us. All right. Now, some of the things that are in this that might not have been in other releases. One, we've got that nice dome base that you see available from round two Polar Lights. It's got that adjustable ball mount so you can mount the ship in any position, and a solid steel rod in chrome. Now, ka-slap, these decals aftermarket to buy this much decals, this detailed, three huge sheets would run you more than they're charging just for the plastic model kit. And you'll get them all in here. Three sheets for every little bit of the hull and the nacelles, all numbered. I mean, look at the detail on that. That's absolutely beautiful. They got that blue tint to them like the filming model. And then we've got the final sheet here. They've even done your trim rings around the bridge or the captain's yacht. And just the detail on those is amazing. And all the little black windows we don't have to paint in. Nothing. We just painted our base color and we'll be able to get that all set. So that's everything that's going to be in the box. All those amazing parts and all those huge decals. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this together real quick. I've picked out my base coat. They recommend a light gray or a robin's egg blue or a light gray on the top there for the hull. This is kind of a mix of both. Winter gray, it's in gloss, so I won't have to gloss coat it to apply the decals. It's a little bit of a blue gray, and I think, you know, it's pretty close to the color it's molded in, but it's a little bit more on the grayish side, so I'm going to really put that on there so I can get a nice base coat. Then what I have to do is paint the phasers and the bay here and these little doors here. Just some small stuff. We also have to paint our ray dome there. I forget exactly what it's called. Deflector shield, deflector right there. And then we also have to do the nacelles. We have to paint those up, and I've got some metallic craft paints that I'll be showing you later. So let me put all this together. That won't take very long. We'll get some paint on it, and we'll be back. any tiny seams filled with super glue and body filler and completely painted as far as the base coat. It's going to be time to start hand painting the very minor details that the decals don't cover. We'll have to paint the sides of the nacelles. We'll have to paint all the different engine looks to it. As you can see, this model would be pretty much impossible to light, even if you wanted to, unless you started rebuilding a lot of it with clear styrene, and we're not going to be doing that for this review for sure. So what I did was I picked up a bunch of metallic paints from Walmart, less than $2 a container, and these will last me for the rest of my model building career. All right there, we're going to be doing the nacelles with the red and the blue and the gold and the deflector on the front. We're going to be using some pewter, a little bit of a darker gray than the model itself, to do the phaser ring around the top. We'll be doing it around there. We'll be doing that door there. We'll be painting in the engines with the different, the darker shade of metallic red. I've got two shades of it right there. So we're going to be working on the kit and just doing, like I said, these phaser rings. These areas here and back here, we'll be all doing with hand paint, all these areas here, and then we'll let that dry for a couple hours. Craft paints dry nice and quick. Then we will start the decals. When I get some decals on after the hand painting, we'll take a look, see how we're going. Working on the Enterprise, I've got all the hand painting done. You can see some of that detail on the nacelles with my metallic paints, got those all on there, and we've got like the phaser ring and all that stuff painted on the main hull. What I've begun working on is actually decaling everything, and it's going to take quite a while. There's a lot of decals on here. What I did was I decided to cut out all the decals and get them ready for the top of the ship and the top of the nacelles, the top of the what do they call that, the battle hull with the nacelles on it. So I've got that all decaled up. I've used a considerable amount of the decals. I've used the entire first sheet. I've got this much that I'm working on the second sheet with right there, and then I've got this remaining, which you can clearly see is the bottom of the saucer section. So what I'm going to do is I've been cutting out decals and applying them. What I do, I apply a layer of my decal solution on the area where the decal is going, then I dip it in water, of course, and I slide it on. And then I apply another layer of decal solvent, and then I move on to the next section. I've continued working on that. I've got some registration marks I need to put on still, some other areas on the top of the hull, and then we're completely done. So I'm going to let this sit for a few hours to dry off and let the decals shrink into their forms around the compound curves and everything. And then I will come back and flip the ship over and work on the bottom of the hull, get those decals on, let the bottom of the hull dry up, then I'll apply a flat coat to everything, and we're all done. So if I have any issues, I'll let you go, and I'll come back, and if I have any problems or anything, if I'm having a lot of issues getting decals on, I can give you some tips. But right now, as long as you use decal solvent, they're sliding on exactly where they need to go and conforming down to the compound curves in the multiple areas on the hull. Some of my favorite tools to use, of course, are good stainless steel tweezers, including self-closing ones. Q-tips work lovely to slide the decals around on the surface, just get it soaking wet. I use an old dish, a very large old dish from the kitchen, filled with warm bath temperature water about body temp. You can also use a brush. You dip it in the water, you brush it on the area. We use the brush inside the decal solvent. We've got toothpicks for the super small decals. If they don't move, we gently persuade them into place. All different techniques, and then I got these little mini cutting mats a while ago for a couple bucks a piece at an outlet store, and those work great for putting it on the towel, cutting my next round of decals out, quickly getting it out of the way. And I like working on a towel because it's much more forgiving. If you drop a decal on it, it doesn't stick to a towel. It sits on top of the fibers, and you can peel it off and place it on the ship. We'll let that all dry off now for the next few hours. We'll be back for another update. Thank you. Here we are, the gorgeous Enterprise D, Picard's Enterprise from the Next Generation, my most favorite Star Trek Enterprise ship of them all, because this show came out when I was about 11 years old or something like that, 10 years old. I'm not exactly sure the exact year, but I've loved it ever since. My uncle introduced me to the show. We were working on one of his places, and he's like, Chris, have you ever seen this new Star Trek show? And I decided to watch it, and I thought it was absolutely amazing. And like every young man on the planet, I had a crush on Dr. Crusher and Deanna Troi, because that's what you do for the Enterprise D from Star Trek The Next Generation. Easy to build kit, snaps together. If you didn't want to use a drop of paint on this, you wouldn't have to. You could just use those amazing Aztec decals and come out with a really nice looking kit. For the kiddos, they could do this pretty easy. If they just wanted to do a little bit of hand painting on the nacelles and leave the saucer rings alone, they could still get a nice looking ship. But just putting a little bit of paint on it, painting those engines up with some metallics, painting that deflector in the front, painting the phaser rings and the cargo bays makes it look extra, extra awesome. The decals, as you saw, go on really nicely, and we've got that nice base with the ball mount on it. I glued it into position to hold it up at an angle. It is a little heavy for that ball mount as it is. If it's a little loose, just put a little glue on it. It'll hold it in any position. Otherwise, if you just wanted to mount it completely level and flat, the pipe itself will fit into the bottom of the ship, and you can solid mount it. I did spray the base with a couple different colors to make it look like a different planet, and I sprayed the stand rod with a flat black just to hide it a little bit and make the base and the actual ship, which is our focal point, stand out. So it looks absolutely lovely. It's going to take a very proud place on my shelves since I like Picard so much and the entire crew of the Enterprise D. Thanks for watching this review. We've got more kits coming up as always, and we will see you on the workshop.